Hi, Dr. Hagmeier here today, and I want to share with you today six warning signs and mistakes that are really being made when it comes to those individuals who are battling a thyroid problem. Now, these are mistakes that I see being made day in and day out, and these mistakes are really costing and robbing individuals their lives and time in getting proper treatment and management for their condition. Now, if any of these warning signs are happening to you and really apply to you, more than likely your thyroid is really stemming from an immune mechanism, and really time is of the essence here. Now, the autoimmune condition is called Hashimoto's disease, and the longer you don't get proper care, the more destruction that's being done to the thyroid, the more irreversible the condition becomes, and the worse your symptoms are going to get. So here's what we do know. We know that according to the Endocrine Society, 80 to 90% of hypothyroidism here in the United States is caused by an autoimmune mechanism. That really means that 8 out of every 10 women that have this problem, the immune system's attack on the thyroid is the problem, not the thyroid gland itself. Again, that is really important. So the cause of the problem here is the immune system, not the thyroid. Now, this should really get you wondering and really just asking the question, well, why is it that my doctor, why are they not doing anything for my immune system? If you think you have Hashimoto's, then the treatment that you're currently receiving, which is probably either Synthroid or levothyroxine, is not enough for your particular condition. Again, we're going to talk about these six warning signs that your thyroid symptom probably is caused by an autoimmune condition. We're going to discuss that in this video, so stay tuned. So here's number one. Number one is that your thyroid is not being properly managed if you're still suffering with symptoms, so despite taking your thyroid medication. So if you're still losing hair, you're still exhausted, you're still drained all the time, you still can't sleep, you're still having headaches and migraines, you're still depressed or experiencing anxiety, or you're still having trouble losing weight despite dieting and exercise, if this is happening to you, you need to be aware that your doctor is missing something and you need to have some additional testing done. What you want to walk away and take away from this is that your health's a whole lot more than just a bunch of numbers on a piece of paper, okay? So number two is it relates to fluctuating TSH levels. This is extremely common and is another major problem where you want to start thinking that your low thyroid symptoms are really caused by an autoimmune mechanism. So these ups and downs with your thyroid levels has to do with how aggressive your immune system is attacking your thyroid gland. The more aggressive the attack on the thyroid gland, the worse your symptoms become. So here's what's important to understand. As you start to lose functionality of the thyroid, the hormones will start to spill over into your body's bloodstream. And this is what causes the ups and downs and swings of your TSH, simply because your TSH is influenced by those hormones, those T3 and T4 hormones. Now, when this happens, you're going to find out that you're either being over-medicated or you're being under-medicated with thyroid hormones. And again, this leaves not only the doctor who's managing your thyroid frustrated, but the patient who's only trying to do and follow the doctor's instructions, the patient who only really wants to just get better. Now, the third warning sign that you could have an autoimmune thyroid or just that your doctor is mismanaging your thyroid has to do with the dose of your thyroid replacement. If your thyroid medication is constantly going up and going down, this really means that you're losing more and more of your thyroid functionality. I want you to think of it like this. If you have a big bucket, and inside that bucket is the immune system that's punching holes in the sides of that bucket, and those holes in the bucket is really where you're having thyroid hormones leak out. Now, you can keep dumping more and more thyroid hormones into the top of that bucket, but the fact of the matter is those hormones just keep spilling out of those holes. That is, until you identify really what are the factors that are causing these holes in the bucket, you're going to continue to lose hormones. So you have to figure out what is causing those holes in the bucket. So if you notice that your doctor keeps changing your thyroid dosage, then again, your immune system is most likely the culprit. And why don't you just start thinking that you potentially could have Hashimoto's? At this point, it should be really clear to you that there's a whole lot more to the thyroid than simply taking thyroid replacement. It's not just a matter of too little or too much thyroid hormone. There's really many factors that are influencing thyroid function. These factors could be related to the hormones, they could be related to digestive function, they could be related to the liver functionality, they could be food sensitivities, There could be neurotransmitter imbalances. And again, all of these causes really need to be investigated. Okay, so if your doctor is not addressing the immune's attack, the immune system's attack on the thyroid, or any of these other factors that I just mentioned, you're never going to get better, and you're going to continue to go down that line of suffering. And what happens often for a lot of these people is they go from doctor to doctor, they go from one medication to the next, and you really never get well. You're never truly well. So this brings us to number four. Number four is this, is your doctor tells you that your thyroid is now in the normal range. I have to tell you that this could be one of the most dangerous words a low thyroid sufferer will ever hear. So in other words, if you're still feeling terrible and your doctor is telling you that your thyroid is normal and he or she just tells you that you're just stressed out or you just need to take a vacation or your doctor just sends you home with some sort of antidepressant or some other type of medication, this is where your health can really start going downhill. I often, to be honest with you, I just cringe when I talk to patients who feel terrible, but the doctor has told them that everything is normal. You have to be really careful here, and here's where common sense really goes a long way. If you feel that your doctor is prescribing medications for your symptoms, and he or she is pretty much has given up on really trying to figure out what's wrong with you, you may want to find another doctor, okay? Another example of how your thyroid is being mismanaged brings us to number five, and this is where your doctor never checks your antibodies against the gland. So if you suffer with hypothyroidism, statistically, you have a very high probability that your problem is autoimmune thyroid. So if your doctor didn't bother to check your antibody levels or refuses to check your antibody levels, here again, you're not receiving the proper treatment and management for your condition. Now remember what we said earlier, 80 to 90% of low thyroid sufferers have an autoimmune condition. That is, even if your TSH is at the normal level, okay? Research shows that a person can have completely normal TSH levels, but antibodies can just be completely off the chart, okay? So it's not normal. Here's the point. It's not normal to have antibodies against the gland or tissues in your body, okay? If those antibodies come back positive, you've got a problem, okay? This is, again, why you really want to push your doctor to have those antibodies checked. Now, here's what you want to have checked. You want to have your doctor check you for something called TPO antibodies. This stands for thyroid peroxidase antibodies. It's very, very important. Thyroid peroxidase antibodies. The other antibody you want to have checked is your thyroglobulin antibodies. Again, very, very important. So you want your TPO antibodies, you want your thyroglobulin antibodies. Now, you might be watching this video and thinking, well, my doctor did run those antibodies. They were positive, but the doctor didn't do anything different with my treatment. He or she really still prescribed thyroid replacement. Well, here's where the patient really needs to be educated. You're going to need to work with a doctor who's going to be able to identify all of the things that are really priming this immune system and the attack on the thyroid gland. So things like your male and female hormones, things like systemic inflammation, things like food sensitivities, things like vitamin deficiencies, things like parasites or chronic viruses, things like neurotransmitters, and a whole host of other things really need to be looked into. So if you want more information about the kinds of testing that you're going to need, I really want to encourage you to go to my website, read my blogs, or even contact our office, okay? So number six, we talked a little bit about this here earlier. This is where your doctor, again, starts playing Russian roulette with just a variety of different medications. At this point, your doctor really has become frustrated with your poor response to his or her treatment. They don't know what else to do with you, and so you begin to get prescription medications for various thyroid symptoms. So it usually starts out where maybe you're on an anti-anxiety medication, then you're on an antidepressant, then it's sleeping pills, then it's pills for migraines, then it's statins for the high cholesterol, then it's blood pressure medications for the high blood pressure. And before you know it, you're on seven or eight different medications and you're wondering how this all happened. Okay, so again, treatment needs to be focused on modulating the immune system, identifying the mechanisms behind your low thyroid function, and then treating this condition with thyroid replacement is not going to be the answer. Okay, that's really important. So you can't just treat the thyroid with hormone replacement while ignoring that immune component that we just talked about. The analogy I would use here is that this is like trying to put out a massive fire with a garden hose that has a bunch of holes and a bunch of leaks in it. You can use these warning signs outlined in this guide to determine whether or not you are receiving the proper management of your thyroid condition, but ultimately, what you need to do is you need to become educated about your condition. You need to take action. Again, the sooner you take action, the better. I'm Dr. Hagmeyer. I hope you enjoyed today's video. For more information, visit my site, www.drhagmeyer.com. But remember this, every choice that you make is either the wind in your sails or the anchor in your boat. You can get better from this terrible condition. You just need to find a doctor who's going to spend the time investigating the cause. Take care.